talking about here. We're talking about some of the must watch on Netflix and of course on YouTube. We've got this guy in with us. He's actually virtually in with us. He is actually Tomas Gongora. He's an entrepreneur and he works very hard. Tomas, good morning, partner. How you doing?
Good morning, guys. How's the morning? Hoping everything is good on your end. Everybody's staying safe and keeping clean.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's we're practicing our social distance. Our hands are clean. Everything is going A-OK.
All right.
So, you know, one of the things that I saw, especially this morning, that there are new trends coming coming along, and people are actually going outside and working out. But the window for that is very small. It's 5 a.m. to 8 a.m., some 3 hours. Thereafter, you go home, you probably make breakfast, you do some cleaning, and then what? You go onto your computer, but what is there to see and watch? So let's talk about some of the Netflix and some of the YouTube things that we can do.
All right, well, I came up with, I guess you can say, cut down list of my favorite shows on Netflix as well as my favorite channels that I subscribe to on YouTube. Mm-hmm. And I think there's a little bit of something for everybody in there. Let's start off with the YouTube. During this time, it's very important to keep your brain engaged. You don't want to get complacent. You don't want to get lazy and stop learning things on a daily basis or what have you. So there's a channel called Thoughty, T-H-O-U-G-H-T-Y, and the number 2, mm-hmm. Which is basically a young man from England who has all kinds of information about everything, and he gives it to you in a somewhat comedic way and in layman's terms so that anybody can digest the information that he's giving. He talks about politics, he talks about history. 5 months ago, he actually talked about the beginning of the COVID-19. Back then it was just called the SARS-2 or something to that effect. And so he has a lot of insight on everything. He's just has a plethora of information. And it's if you watch one or two of his episodes every day, you'll be surprised the amount of things you can learn.
Nice. Okay.
So,
this is on YouTube, right?
This is YouTube. I'm going down the list of the top 5 YouTube shows that I watch right now.
So can I just segue a bit, because I know that many of us use our mobiles, some of us use our laptops, but you can also watch YouTube on your television as well, a smart TV, that is.
Yes, if you have a smart TV or a Fire Stick, you can get the YouTube app on there, and you can just watch this right on your TV. So you don't have to constantly have your phone in your hand or around your laptop. You can put on your TV, walk around your home. Yeah. In most cases, you can just even listen. But he does have interesting photos and video clips that, you know, would really like spark your attention.
Okay. All right. So that's definitely one to check out.
Yes.
What else?
So number 2 would be Chilled Cow. Chilled Cow is basically instrumental music that you can put on in the background while you're cooking, cleaning, or even if you're working from home, as I have the privilege of doing, or if you're even working out. Chilled Cow is just very relaxing music that'll help you kind of free your mind of stress and all the dramas of the COVID-19 and all the information that we have to take in every day.
Yeah.
So it's something just to relax your mind, no words, just music. And it really, really helps me when I'm working from home.
Chilled Cow,
yeah.
So it's kind of just like good background music that you can have.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
You can put that on and you can just let it play. It'll play over and over, like not over and over, but it'll play like endless amounts of nice, relaxing music.
All right.
Yeah. Let's get to number 3.
Number 3 on my YouTube list is called alux.com. That's not a website. That's the name of their page, alux.com. And it's basically what people would refer to as a lifestyle page. Mm. It tells you, they constantly have videos of the top 15 of this and the top 10 of that, but it all has to do with motivating you to want a better lifestyle for yourself and motivating you to do things that are consistent with what successful people do in life.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite bit to watch on Alux is their Sunday motivation videos. Every Sunday they have a video that tells you the top 15 things that you should do if you want to be successful in different areas of life.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of people out there who are lifestyle experts and who subscribe to other life coaches and stuff like that, but Alux is one of the ones that, I kind of watch. And it's pretty interesting.
Yeah.
Some people would say it's a bit superficial because they talk a lot about luxury and wealth and stuff like that, but who doesn't want to live like that?
Oh, definitely.
Well, it's like a collect somebody who collects little great factoids for you. That's what it looks like.
Yeah, basically that's what it is. And it's the same as with 32, except his is just general information and this has to do more with lifestyle.
Okay, yeah. Nice. Yeah. Okay.
So my next channel that I like is called Colors. It's another music channel, but this one has to do with younger and undiscovered artists. Mm-hmm. And it's called Colors because when you look at the videos, it's literally just an artist on a colorful background with a microphone hanging in the middle. Mm-hmm. And what they do is they categorize the artists, like each color signifies a different style of music. So there's, you know, more chill music, there's hip hop type music, there's jazzy type music, but it's all about showcasing artists and putting them on a colorful background for you to enjoy just them and their music. And you know, as a DJ and a music buff, I like to listen to new artists. I like to see if I can be ahead of the curve in terms of listening to artists that are lesser known and maybe undiscovered as yet.
Definitely.
And that channel does a great job of keeping you up to date with that. And they're very, very talented people. They don't put rubbish on their channel.
I like the use of the word rubbish.
Yeah. So that's number four. Number five for me on YouTube would be HubSpot. HubSpot is the official YouTube page of the website, HubSpot.com. Mm-hmm. And they do tutorials and educational videos where marketing and sales is concerned. That's their specialty. They give free trainings in marketing and sales, and it's excellent for anybody who either is already a professional marketer or salesperson, or someone who's an entrepreneur who wants to buff up on their marketing and sales skills.
Okay.
So you can go on HubSpot and they have videos about anything and everything. And even though I've been a professional marketer for about 20 years now, I still learn something new every time they post a video. You can never stop learning in this game.
Yeah.
That's an excellent way, again, to stay ahead of the curve, because that's what I'm all about. I like to try and stay ahead of the curve.
But of course, so these are your top five for YouTube.
For YouTube, yes.
All right. Well.
So now, moving on to Netflix.
That's right.
Yeah, let's get into it, man. There are a lot of things out there that people would want to know about when it comes to Netflix or what to watch.
Okay. So, spoiler alert, Tiger King is not on this list.
I was gonna ask you that. I've not seen it. I've clearly heard everyone telling me you need to watch Tiger King. Is it worth it?
It is to me, you know.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I have watched the entire season, including the one extra video that they added earlier in April. But it's not in my top, I wouldn't put it in my top five, because to be honest with you, I would prefer, during this time, that's good for entertainment, but during this time, I would prefer to keep my mind engaged in a more positive way, because there's a lot of things in Tiger King that, you know, people would frown upon, like the abuse of animals and that sort of thing.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, that's true.
So
what you're saying is it's not a good way to numb your mind.
Yeah, exactly. So my one vice when it comes to Netflix would have been Ozark, which is my number one on my Netflix list.
Mm-hmm.
Ozark is a very well-written series about money laundering after the drug game is over. So it's what happens when they get the money.
Yeah.
I watch it more because the storyline is so complex and entertaining that if you blink for a second, you miss something important.
It shows you quite a lot of how businesses function. I just finished Ozark, season three this weekend.
Yeah. I've heard a lot about it, but I've never, like, I guess I need to start.
Yeah.
So I've heard a lot about it.
One of the things that I would recommend you watch it for, John, is because if you put aside the whole part about the drug game and everything, there's a lot of useful information in there about investing in businesses, because the guy, in the star of the show, Jason Bateman, his character goes around investing in businesses in this community of Ozark as a way of laundering the money, yes, but the way he invests in businesses in the show teaches you the things to look out for and think about when you're looking to invest in a business or start a business of your own.
Wow.
And since that's a part of what I do at Bell Trade, it's a lot of useful information in there, and it also helps you on the flip side. If you're looking for investors, it helps you to spot when somebody is looking to use your business to launder money and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it helps you in that regard, right?
Okay. Yeah. All right.
So number two on my list is something that was just added on Sunday. It's called The Last Dance.
Yeah.
And The Last Dance, as most sports buffs will tell you.
Oh, that's the Michael Jordan
Michael
one?
Michael Jordan thing, yeah.
Okay.
It's the show about the last season that the Chicago Bulls won the World Championship. But again, as somebody who is business-minded, I like it because it tells you the business behind sports.
Yes.
We watch the games and we see the entertaining side of it and
you
so
don't know
on.
What's
but
behind
the business
it.
Goes on behind the scenes is like, you know, really lucrative, and also there's a lot of politics involved in it and a lot of drama as well.
Yeah.
Is it good?
Really it is.
Two episodes every week, so you can only watch the first two episodes right now, and then if you watch on ESPN, you can watch it on Sunday, but it's also on Netflix, and that comes out on Monday morning.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So, all right. So my next.
So those people who are really missing ESPN right now, they're going to love The Last Dance, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. The Last Dance. Was
very nice. Very nice.
Okay.
And they have fresh interviews with all the players who are on the team. So if you're tired of seeing all the old school videos and the old school flashbacks on ESPN or on TV.
Yeah.
This is a fresh take on everything that was going on around that time, you know, and where the guys are now in life.
Nice.
Definitely.
Everybody in Belize is a big Chicago Bulls fan. Well, was back in the days because, you know, we had the BGN. And so that's definitely something that I was pleasantly surprised to find out about.
Okay.
All right. Next on my list. It's a kind of a tie because they're similar shows. There's Dirty Money and there's Rotten. And those both sound, those are both shows about businesses, right?
Yeah.
And it talks about, again, all the drama and stuff that goes on behind the scenes of big businesses in the world.
Yeah.
Dirty Money is about businesses in general. There was an episode about the big diesel scam that Volkswagen had a while back. And there's talks about the maple syrup business in Canada, and how it's run kind of like a mafia.
Yeah, it really shows you kind of the unscrupulous ways that people are doing business. I like Dirty Money.
Yes, and
I mean
Rotten
the show
is,
Dirty Money.
Yeah. And Rotten is similar about it's, but it's more about the food business specifically, how food is moved around the world, the business side behind it, the chain of command when it comes to who decides on the pricing and value of certain things and so on.
Yeah.
And again, because at Bell Trade, we deal with exporting of products and developing of products and stuff like that. It's something that I found very interesting, and a lot of the things that I saw on there come into play when I'm working with entrepreneurs and other businesses.
Yeah. So, you've got two number threes.
Yeah, there's two number threes.
Nice.
All right.
So number four is Atypical. Atypical is actually a dramatic series about a young man with autism and him coming into adulthood and finding his place in the world and in life. As someone who has a child with autism, and also because World Autism Awareness Day was celebrated on April 2nd this year, this is something that I highly recommend. Autism affects a lot of families, even more people than you would even imagine.
Yeah.
But it comes in different levels, and Atypical helps you to understand, especially if you have a child with autism. It's I see it almost as a resource, because even though it's a show with a plot and a storyline and so on, it shows you a realistic side of dealing with a child with autism or anybody who has autism, and it shows you from the perspective of that person as close as possible as they could come to analyzing someone with autism, how they move through life and how they see things and how they perceive things.
Mm-hmm.
So it's helped me a lot because my son is 6 years old. We found out he had autism about 4 years ago or 3 years ago. And it's helped me a lot to understand how he thinks and how he operates, and it helps you to be more patient and to deal with things like outbreaks and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I love that show, and anybody who has a child with autism or knows somebody with autism should really watch
check
that show.
Out.
Okay. It has a whole plot driven into written into it as well. So it's not just like advocacy work; it's a show.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
And you learn a lot in there as well, because people with autism tend to be very meticulous, and they tend to find a talent or a skill to focus on. Mm-hmm. And if you watch the show, you know that this kid was an expert in anything that had to do with Antarctica. And as trivial as that may seem, you learn a lot.
Yeah.
And it helps. So it gives them something to focus on and a purpose in life, basically.
All right. So, number five.
Okay, number five is another tie, again, because of the similarity between the shows, and, you know, I just couldn't choose between one or the other. So one is called Defiant Ones, another one is called Hip Hop Evolution. Again, as a music buff, this is something that I really enjoyed watching. Defiant Ones focuses on the career of Dr. Dre and Jimmy Iovine, who discovered Dr. Dre. Mm-hmm. And it actually tells you from the very beginning how Dr. Dre and Jimmy Iovine became a team and how they were able to become basically one of the most successful, richest tandems in hip hop and music in general.
Yeah.
I think at this point, collectively, they're worth a few $1 billion. But one of the things was interesting to find out was the list of artists that they helped nurture into fame as well. So it's not just about them, but it's about the people they've helped along the way,
yeah.
Which to me is something that's very interesting in today's world in music, especially here in Belize. And you do see a lot of people helping each other along and supporting each other and stuff like that, but there's something that we're just missing, something that we haven't hit as yet. We haven't hit that sweet spot as yet where people are able to actually make a real career out of music, fall back on a second job and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But that gives you a good idea of the business side of music again. And if you notice, there's a theme going with the shows that I like, telling you about the business side of different industries, right?
Yeah.
Hip Hop Evolution, I'm a hip hop lover. That's my favorite genre of music, and it has been since, you know, I found out about hip hop. And it tells you about the road from when hip hop started in New York, way back in the day, to where we are now. There's still more that's going to be added to the series, but it helps you to get a better understanding of how these different subgenres of hip hop came about and what was the influence behind different artists doing music the way they do and the content that they rap about.
Yeah.
Nice.
So, you know, if you're into hip hop or even poetry, because they're hand in hand, that's something
that's
that
true.
You okay. So that rounds out my top five, but I want to give honorable mentions to a show called Comedians of the World, which has different collections of comedians from different countries in the world.
Yeah.
Also another show called Our Planet, which is basically...
I love Our Planet.
Yeah.
It's a scientific look
at
the world around us and all the, you know, how things work. And if you're a science geek, you will fall in love with that show and you will watch it end to end.
But just the imagery, I mean, if you're locked indoors, it's just the perfect thing to watch, because so beautiful when you look at the photography of the show. But
definitely. Mm-hmm. And that is one of the most appealing things to me too, because I look at that and I'm like, how the hell did you guys get that shot?
You know, I always think of how long they're waiting.
Waiting for the perfect shot, yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Waiting. That's nice,
All right.
Well, thank you for sharing. We know this is a big task because everyone has different tastes. And, you know, we it's always hard to make a list out of favorites of anything. But we really appreciate it. You've really pointed out some new ones for me to go and check out as well. So there is the time on the weekends. We'll get to them.
One thing I want to leave off with, I want to encourage people, even though these are great series and great channels to watch, don't spend all your time binging.
Yeah.
It's important to still try and find some kind of routine to go through. Yeah. Myself, I have actually resorted to exercising during this time. I've lost
exercising?
Yeah, well, I'll be honest with you. I was one of those people who was like, I'm not going to exercise too much. You know, but recently, and luckily I'm in a position where I can exercise at home, and I have I have motivation from friends around me to continue doing so. But I mean, if that's not your thing, find something else to keep yourself occupied as well. Be innovative. If you're business minded, try to think about how you can continue to do your business from home, and how you can continue to keep your audience engaged. But it's very important to try and find out what is your new normal and kind of follow your routine.
And I think what you just mentioned too, in terms of exercise, there's some great YouTube videos that you can follow just about anything you're looking for, whether it's cardio or HIIT or yoga or meditation. You know, like there, you can just find someone that you like and follow them and do their videos.
There's a lot of that happening even on a local level. There's doing free yoga classes on Instagram. I had the privilege of DJing for someone on Sunday who does the same. There's people who are giving free classes online that they would normally charge for at this time. People just want to stay engaged with their audience. So right now is a good time, if you're a consumer, to look around and see what would interest you and try and do
Try out new things. I mean, maybe you won't like it. That's fine, but just try it. This is the time. You have that. If you are not occupied with working at home or caring for the children or anything else, when you do have free time, go ahead and try something new.
Definitely.
Well, thank you so much for the recommendations.
Thank you, buddy.
We do appreciate it.
Always a pleasure, guys.
Thank you very much. All right. Stay safe.
All right.
Yeah. Well. So there you have it. That's the recommendations for YouTube and Netflix shows that you can check out, courtesy of Tomas Gongora.
Yep.
DJ Dizzle.
He did.